everyone, welcome to the Phyllis Intim Show. The man that I'm about to interview is one of the most sought after music producers and sound engineers in Ghana. He won the Sound Engineer of the Year at the Vodafone Ghana Music Awards in 2012, 2013, 2014, and 2016. Hey,
Mark. Hi.
How are you doing?
Okay.
How was your stay been in Amsterdam?
Pretty nice, just too cold. Yeah.
So tell me how your journey started in music production and sound engineering.
Well, I started with a passion when I was in secondary school, and then passion grew into reality because I had people to support me. And so through the support of my mom, Dad didn't support at first, but as time went on, he supported. And so through the support of these people, I am who I am today. And through they actually believed in me. And so it is the fact that they believed in me and gave me the opportunity to become who I am today. I'm seated here.
Yeah. And for how long were you in training in regards to music production and sound engineering?
Well, I believe that in everything, you just need to put your head into it. You need to understand what you're going to do first and then go get some training. And so, of course, I went to an engineering school in Tema, Ghana, called Bell Bottom Recording School. And so I was there for 4 years. And I started recording.
And why the name Kewa?
Well, still don't understand why the name Kewa, but some friends gave me the name Kewa. I think it was way back in secondary school. And then I just had to. Initially, I didn't like the name, but it was getting so weird. I had to take a name like that. So I took it, and today Kewa is a household name.
Which big artist did you really start working with?
Well, I think I worked with Reggie Rockstone, then I worked with Trigger Bear Mothers, then was very big in Ghana, still big though. And worked with Samini, you know, all these guys. So I actually started working with the superstars.
So, but who was the first big artist that you worked with?
I don't remember, but I think it was Reggie Rockstone.
Okay. And what song did you produce for him?
I actually mixed his album for him.
And what's the name of the album?
If you ask me, I don't know. You know, it's only his album, think about the sound. So, but he, when you ask him, you remember the album I mixed for him. But it was just a mix and master this project. I also worked with Mark Tonto, a song about Africa, Mark Tonto Samini. And it was about Africa also at the same time.
And which year did you work with Reggie Rockstone?
I think that I around 1990, around 2000. Yes, because I really started my studio around around 2002. In 2002 I started recording. So that's when I, around the same time I got him to work with in the studio.
Okay. What are some of the struggles you initially faced in your music production and sound engineering?
Well, obviously the first thing is support. I had some people in my family support, some people didn't have support. And also gadgets to work with and softwares. Then softwares are pretty expensive. And even the recording that I just worked with were very expensive, and so I had to maneuver and work with the little I can get gradually. And I also worked with artists who didn't pay money to work with, because you had to get yourself into the industry, and so you had to, you need the support, you know, you need to impress people so they can actually work with you. Third, my studio was in a certain area where no studio was found, where nobody would love to travel all the way from Accra to Tema to record. You know, so it was difficult for me, but I persevered, I didn't give up. So in my struggle and in my push, because of the good work and obviously the help of God, It worked.
Do you still have a studio in town?
Yes, still the same place.
Why did you choose Highly Spiritual as your signature tune?
Well, you know, I believe in branding. And me as a sound engineer, from the time I started to now, I've had several names. I've had Kase Kewa, I don't know what I could talk. I've had Slicker Than the Average. I've had a lot. So, Highly Spiritual is how I brand. Yes, Kewa, but when you hear Highly Spiritual, it means that you're going to be somewhere. It's not like I'm a man or I am something that's. I believe in spiritual things if you do too. Unless you don't.
Good. Apart from the Sound Engineer of the Year award from the VGMA, what are the other awards that you've won?
Well, I've won Producer of the Year for Mogo Awards, I think, CDFM, and I've won other awards. As I look at my awards, I can tell you what awards they are, but I've won a couple of awards.
Okay. Are you going to collaborate with other artists anytime soon?
I have collaborated with a lot of artists ever since I started. And so I will not stop. I will continue to do that.
Yeah. Can you name some of the artists that you're going to work with soon?
Well, lately I have signed new artists. I've signed 5+1 already. I have Kel Songs. And I've signed 5 more on my record label now. I've signed 2 producers who are working with me now on my record label. So it's a big family now. And we intend to blast the music system. What we are going to bring out will surprise everybody. It's going to be a new year.
How did you come in contact with Kel Songs?
Well, Bolo Bana, I'm TN Hitmaker. And then I think I was his producer then in the MTV Hitmaker. So after the Hitmaker, the organizers gave him to me for me to work with. And so that's how come all the hit started. And today he's Kel Songs, he's a guy.
And how's it like working with him?
Beautiful. He respects and he understands how I work. And so we gel together.
What are your plans in relation to music this year?
Huge, I told you about that artist I've signed. And we intend to release hits after hits. It's a group, and so we're going to be releasing anthems. We're going to be releasing singles for them also. So it's going to be massive. Something that hasn't happened before, you can say that.
I was listening to Jingang Too Much by Ifeah today for the first time.
Okay.
And I must say I like the beat so much. It was produced by you. I was listening to it for more than 2 hours. Like, seriously.
You loved it.
I really loved the song.
I mean, it was a song I produced, and when I produced the beat, I just knew Ifeah was the right person for the beat. So I called her, and then when she came, she was like, wow, she killed it. Right at the studio, she wrote the lyrics for the song, and then she recorded, and we just put it out.
So for how many days or weeks were you actually, like, you know, in the studio, cooking this song up?
If you have a song?
Yeah.
It took about 2 or 3 days to get it done.
Okay.
There are some songs that take sometimes 6 months to get it done. There are some that takes 2 months. There are some that take 3 days. I called a Castro and Asamajan back on and on. It took 3 days.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, there are songs that takes a day. I recorded a song for Sakonye. Wuntumi say no, it took a day. It depends on what is in the song. It depends on how the song comes out.
So how was it like collaborating with Castro?
It was awesome. I mean, Castro is, he's one of a kind. He's an artist you will desire to work with, because when he's with him, there are a lot of good vibes, good vibes around him. He brings a lot of beautiful things around him. Yeah, so that's Castro. Yeah, so I mean, we are not happy because of that. But we believe that God in His own plan will keep him.
What is the advice you would give to people that want to start their own record label and master their skills in music production and sound engineering?
Number one, it's a good thing to, it's the best thing to, for me, I don't know about a banker, I don't know about whoever, but if you want to do music production, it's the best thing to happen to you. Just do it right. Get, acquire knowledge, go to school, understand how it works, and get it done properly so that you can be a good, you can also be called a good producer, a good sound engineer, and go deeper into it. Don't desire to become like me. Desire to go beyond me. Yeah.
So how did you feel when you won the Sound Engineer of the Year 4 times?
I just knew it was hard work. I knew God was in it. But it was, I just knew it because I put in a lot of hard work. I decided that I will work hard to attain that. So the first time that award was given to me, it was the first time that that was introduced into Ghana Music Awards. But when it was introduced, I took it and I left it for about 2 years and I came to take it again. Yeah.
You're a very hardworking person. I'm really impressed that you won the award like 4 times. Like it's really great.
I know it's not by might. It's the help of God. Yeah.
So you've got a female artist signed to your record label. Rochelle
Blue.
Yeah, so when are we going to hear something from her?
That's something that you're going to hear an anthem from them very soon. Very, very soon. And then you're going to hear their singles also out pretty soon. And back to an anthem, singles, anthem, singles. And so we'll be flooding the market with great songs, great videos. You will be touring the whole world and you'll hear of us. Okay?
Thank you very much for listening.
I appreciate that. It's very important.